How's it going, everyone? Welcome to the first episode of How to Use Photoshop. Now, in this course, I'm going to teach you what exactly Photoshop is and how to use it. And I should mention that I do have two courses on my channel. I have this one that is going to teach you the basics of Photoshop, such as using the tools and what exactly Photoshop is. And I will also have a how-to course that is going to teach you how to do things inside Photoshop, such as removing backgrounds, how to create textures, how to get a certain look and feel inside some images. So I will have two separate playlists inside my YouTube channel. So what we're going to do in this episode here is we're going to talk about what exactly Photoshop is and what you can use it for. So as you can see, when I enter Photoshop for the first time, we get this little screen here. It's probably not going to look like yours because I do have some projects that I recently worked on, so I will have some projects in here, but yours is going to be more or less empty. Now, Photoshop is a program we use for many things. We use it for image manipulation, which is what it's mostly used for. We can use it for creating designs for example, websites. We can use it for creating different artistic work inside Photoshop. A lot of people use it for many different things. So what we're going to do in this episode is we're just going to focus on what exactly Photoshop is, how it works, and some of the different workspaces and tools we have inside Photoshop. So once you open up Photoshop for the first time, what you can do just to sort of get started is we're going to go ahead and go to Create New, or you can go up to File and say New. And inside the pop-up that we get here, you can see there are different templates we can choose from if you want to work from a specific template. So you can work with a photo template. You can always expand it because right now we can only see the first four. So you can click expand to view all presets. And then we have all the different settings you can choose from. We can also work with print, art and illustration, web, mobile, film and video. There's a lot to choose from here. If, however, instead you want to work on something customized, you can also go down here in the right side and you can write in some custom numbers for the width and the height of the document you want to work on and the resolution for it that you want to work on in order to create your own sort of template. So you can create a name for the template and then save it if you want to. We can decide the width, the height, either in pixels or whatever measurement you might have inside the dropdown. And you can also go ahead and choose the resolution. Now, typically, when we talk about pixels per inch, 72 is going to be a low resolution image that is going to be very pixelated if you were to zoom in on it. If you want something medium resolution, then typically we choose 150. And if you want high resolution, we choose 300. So these are sort of the numbers you want to go with depending on the resolution. Just remember, if you want to work on something that needs to be very crisp in its quality, then you need to choose 300 in order to get the best possible quality. So down here at the bottom, we also have something called color mode. Color mode is going to determine what kind of product you're going to make. If you want to make something for a digital screen, then you want to choose RGB color. If you want to work on something for example, print, something you want to print out, then you want to choose CMYK color mode. And then we have grayscale and we have different sort of colors here. We're only going to work primarily with RGB or CMYK or SMYK, like we like to call it. So we're just going to go ahead and focus on RGB in this episode here. Now, for this specific episode, I'm just going to go ahead and go inside print, and I'm going to choose a A4 format. So I'm just going to say A4 and create down here at the bottom. And then you can see we get this window that has different sort of tools going around in the edges and that sort of thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to briefly go over different tools, at least the sections that we have inside Photoshop. And then in a later episode, we're going to take the tools one at a time and talk about what they can do. Now, just to mention this, because I was told this might be an issue for some of my viewers, my face cam up in the top right corner is not covering up anything important. It's only covering up the color palette we have inside Photoshop, which we're not going to use that often inside our program here. So now let's talk about what exactly we have inside Photoshop, because as you can see, now that we opened up a new project and everything, we have a lot of different tools in Windows Open that does a lot of different things. So I want to just sort of go over the different windows just to sort of explain what exactly they do and why they're so important to Photoshop. Now, the first window I want to show you is going to be the artboard that we have in the middle here. So as you can see, the template that I chose and opened inside my project is going to be in the middle of the screen here. We can have many different projects open at the same time up here in the tabs. So as you can see, we can actually close down our project or we can see the name of it. So we have the possibility of many different projects inside our tabs up here. Now, just a couple of tips to save you a lot of time in the future when you want to navigate the artboard. If you want to zoom in and out, you can use Control Plus and Control Minus. And again, I will also have the shortcut for Mac down the bottom here, because I know that a lot of you are going to be working on Macs. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave the shortcut for those as well. I'm a PC guy, so that's why I'm using PC shortcuts. If you want to move around inside the artboard, you can hold down space to get this little hand icon and then click and drag in order to move around the artboard, which is going to be a lot better than using the drag and hold, you know, scroll options we have on the side here. So if you want to save a lot of time, go ahead and use the spacebar to move around the artboard. It's a lot easier. The next thing I want to talk about is going to be the toolbar that we have on the left side. So as you can see, we have a lot of tools going down here. We can also choose colors and that sort of thing. If you want to change the way it looks, you can always click the little arrow up here in the top left corner. And as you can see, it all gets pulled up on two lines instead of one in order to make it easier for some people to look at. Now, in my case, I like to have them on one line because it gives me more space for the artboard. So that's the way I'm going to do it for this episode or for this course here. We also have the top here. When you select the tool on the side, you can see that the top changes to create different settings for the tool you selected. So if I want to, for example, say I want to paint, then we have different paint options for the stroke that I want to use and that sort of thing at the top here, the opacity, the mode, smoothing, that sort of thing. So the top is going to have different options for the tools that we selected on the side here. Now, while the toolbar on the left side is going to give you different tools that you can actually use inside the artboard, the toolbar on the right side is going to give you some different tools depending on different purposes. These are very related to the different windows you see over here on the right side. So if I were to choose one of them, you can see we have history, which means that if I were to do something inside my Photoshop document, you can see that it now registered that I just used my brush tool in order to paint something. So if I made a mistake, I can go ahead and click back in the history and redo what I just did. So the history tool that we have over here, the tab, is very important in order to do whatever you want to do inside Photoshop. So if you make a mistake, you can redo it. We have many different tools here related to paragraphs, text, and that sort of thing. And actions is something we use quite often if we have many different images on your computer that you want to do the same thing to inside Photoshop. Then you can record whatever you're doing inside Photoshop and tell it to do the same thing for all the different images on your computer. So if I want to create a watermark on some of my images, I can do the same thing for all my images inside a folder just by using an action. So I don't have to do it again and again and again on the same image over and over again. Then under my face cam, we also have a couple of different tabs we can choose from. We have the one called color, which allows you to choose a color inside Photoshop. Again, I went ahead and covered that up using my face because we don't really need to use it. And we also have something called swatches, which I went ahead and drag and drop down to the next tab we have down here at the bottom. You can just go ahead and grab one and drag it down to another window if you want to move around all the different things inside Photoshop. So I can just move it up again if you want to. So we can move around and adjust different windows if you want to inside Photoshop. I can do the same thing over here if I want to take my toolbar and drag it out here if I wanted to. I can also drag it to another specific section of Photoshop, so over here next to the other toolbar if I want to. So essentially, you can move around everything inside Photoshop and customize it to whatever way we want it to be. And again, we can just move it back here if we want to. So I'm just gonna, well, as you can see, I just screwed up Photoshop. Again, if you screwed up Photoshop, you can go up here in the right top corner and right behind my face cam, I'm just gonna remove it here so you can actually see, we have an arrow that we can click on and we can choose different modes for our Photoshop interface. So the default one is going to be the one called Essentials. That's the one you've chosen right now. So if I messed up my dashboard, I can actually go ahead, click Essentials, and then you can see everything gets moved back to the default mode that I had before. So everything is going to be reset back to the beginning. So that's a really good shortcut to know if you somehow mess up some windows. Now, before we start talking about the next window where we have adjustments inside of it, I want to drag in a new image inside Photoshop to sort of show you what exactly adjustments can do. So if we were to take an image like the one I have here and just drag it into the top where we have all the different tabs open for the photos, it's very important you don't drag it into the artboard because then it's going to do this and just put the photo inside the artboard. So I'm just going to go ahead and cancel it up here. Instead, if you want to open up a new photo, you need to drag it up into the tabs bar and then release it. Then it opens up a completely new tab with the new photo inside of it. So With the new photo, you can see we have a couple of things going on down here. We have adjustments where we can go ahead and adjust the actual image. So if we want to make it brighter or darker, or if we want to create some contrast, if we want to create different colors or saturations, I can do that using adjustments. So if I want to go in here and say I want to change the curves of the image, which means the light and dark colors, I can go ahead and buff up the lightness of the image and maybe give it some better contrast using the dark colors, and then you can see we get something that changes from the original. We can also go ahead and give it some hue and saturation, so if we want to have really strong colors, I can buff up the colors or make it very saturated by removing colors. There's a lot of things we can do inside adjustments, which is really important when we use Photoshop. And personally, I use adjustments quite often when I do anything with images inside Photoshop. So adjustments is very important to know about. So now that we tried this, you can actually see that something is going on down inside the last window. We have a couple of different layers going on inside the window down here. Now, Photoshop works in layers. This is very important to know. And what I mean by layers is that it works in the same way as if you were to take a sheet of paper and then draw something on it. Then in case we don't want to mess up the original drawing, then we can take a layer and put on top of it, which means a second piece of paper that is transparent. And then we can draw on top of the second piece of paper. Then if I want to just remove the second layer, I can just take away the paper, and then we only have the bottom layer. The same thing goes for Photoshop. So if we were to go ahead and delete the layers that we just created by creating different adjustments, because when we create an adjustment, we create a separate layer with the adjustment, I can just go ahead and delete them here. And now we have the original image back again. Now, if we want to do something to the original image that I drag into Photoshop, we will need to unlock the first layer inside Photoshop. So when we drag in an image, it's going to be locked. That is something that's important to know, because it's going to do that each time you open up a new image inside Photoshop. So to unlock it, I'm going to go down here, and we can either double click the layer, or we can go on the right side where we have this little lock symbol and click it. And now we have the layer unlocked. So now I can actually draw on it and do different things if I want to. Now, this is where layers are really important, because like you can see, I just drew on my image, and maybe I didn't want to draw this specific line over here, but the rest of it is perfect, so I don't want to do anything to it. So what should I do? Well, I could always try and take the eraser and try to erase something on the image. But as you can see, I erased everything, including the image in the background and the line that I drew. So what we can do, if I were to go back inside my history and just revert it back to before I drew the pencil stroke inside the image, and then take my pencil again, what I can do is I can create a new layer, either by saying Control Shift N, or I can go down to the bottom here and click New Layer, which is the second bottom right next to the the trash can icon down at the bottom there. And then you can see we have a new layer inside our layers panel here, which means that now if we were to draw, let's actually go and choose a different color. When I draw something, if I made a mistake, I can either hide the layer, or I can go in and delete part of it. So I can actually delete part of what I drew, but not the background image. So it's very important that we have layers inside Photoshop. And as well, if I want to delete a layer, I can actually go ahead and select the layer, click delete on my keyboard, or we can drag and drop it down to the trash bin icon down here at the bottom, and then we don't have the layer anymore. So Photoshop works in layers. This is a very important concept to know when getting started with Photoshop, because a lot of the things you're going to do are going to work in layers. Now, the last thing I want to show you before we end off this episode is the fact that we also have a menu at the top here. So you can see we have File, Edit, Image, Layer, Type, Select, Filter, 3D, View, Window, and Help. And if there's a specific window that you accidentally close down, if it were to go to, for example, let's go to Adjustments, and say I want to close it. Whoops, I don't have adjustments anymore. I can go up to Window, and say I want to select Adjustments. And then you can see we get it again inside our Photoshop panel. So if there's any kind of window that you accidentally close, or that you don't have inside of here as a default, because believe me, there's going to be a lot of windows in here that you don't have inside the dashboard as a default. So if you were to watch a future tutorial on some kind of YouTube channel, and they say, well, we need to access the, I don't know, histogram window, but you don't have it inside Photoshop, you can go in here, select the window, and then drag it out so you have it. So I could, for example, say I want to have the navigator, whoa, now we have a navigator up here. And again, if I don't want it, I can just sort of close it down if I want to. So I can just say close, and now I don't have it anymore. Now, I'm not going to go in details about the menu we have at the top there because there's a lot of different settings in there, and we will get to them in future episodes. But for now, we're just going to go ahead and talk about the fact that we have something called File that allows for you to create a new file inside Photoshop. And you can also go ahead and save the existing file you have inside Photoshop. So you can just go ahead and click Save or Save As, and then you can go ahead and save it as a certain format, such as Photoshop files, which is the project file for Photoshop. So if you want to open up your project with all the settings saved and everything, then you can just go ahead and save it as a Photoshop format. Or if you want to save it as an image, you can go and select it as a JPEG or PNG or whatever you might want to have as an image. So there's a lot of settings here. Now, I hope my video clarified on what exactly Photoshop is and what you can use it for. And in the future, we'll have many more episodes on different tools and how to use Photoshop if you want to do something specific. And I will also go ahead and have that second playlist that is going to show how to do specific things using Photoshop, such as, like I said, removing background images and that sort of thing. So I will have a separate playlist. So once you get more familiar with Photoshop, go ahead and check that one out and see if there's anything new you can learn from them. So I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.